Everyone,
good afternoon.
Are you feeling the winter yet? I don't think Bombay mein abhi tak winter aaya hai, yeah, na?
No, it will take at least 10 days.
10 days.
Because here the problem comes here, the all tall buildings are there. Yeah. So because of that, there is. No
and we
problem.
Cut the forests. We are guilty of it.
No proper atmosphere. No?
Yeah. So welcome everyone, and thank you for being present. My name is Sharmee Divan, and I am here to talk about a topic that really, really took me deep into this journey of batch flower remedies, which is pregnancy and batch flower remedies. I will give you a brief understanding of what these 38 remedies are all about, what the system is all about, and who invented this system, and then we will dig a little bit deep into our topic of the day, which is about taking batch flower remedies when you are pregnant or when you have somebody that is pregnant and you are taking care of that person. So a little understanding of the system. This system was invented by a British doctor. His name was Dr. Edward Bach, hence the name batch flower remedies. And they were discovered sometime in the 1920s, 30s. And as he went along his journey of discovering the remedies, he started to gather, you know, bit by bit, you know, from like initial 9 to 12 to 19, and then completed the set at 38 remedies. So this is a system which is very simple, which is very close to nature. It is made from nature. So these are all flowers that are used in the remedies, which is why batch flowers, except for one, which is water from a spring. And the rest of the remedies are very much flowers. And they are divided into 7 different groups that I have listed down over here. So the first group is fear, the second one is uncertainty, the third one is insufficient interest in present circumstances, the fourth one is loneliness, the fifth one is oversensitivity to influence and ideas, the seventh one is despondency and despair, and the sixth one and the seventh one is over care for the welfare of others. So this is how the remedies are divided, so that it is easier for us to remember them. It is easier for us to place even when we are taking a consultation as practitioners. So I happen to be a registered practitioner with the Batch Institute. So I do have an ongoing practice, and I'm their teacher in training at the moment. A little bit about the learning of the remedies. We have divided the learning into 3 parts. So the level 1 introduces you to the remedies and the system and the philosophy of Dr. Edward Bach. I'll talk a little bit briefly about it. And the second level kind of helps you dig a little bit deeper into the remedies, talks about what are type remedies, what are mood remedies, you know, a consultation, what does that look like. So a little bit of understanding of that, which completes your learning of the remedies. And then the third one is the practitioner level. And in the practitioner level, you basically hone the skills, you learn the skills to enhance your abilities as a practitioner. That's how the levels are divided, and you don't have to go anything beyond these 3 levels to become a registered practitioner with us. So I'm not going to talk about each and every remedy over here, but to understand what the system is all about. So Dr. Bach was a very simple man. And initially, of course, he was a Harley Street physician, which is, you know, a very elite place where doctors used to practice back in the days. And he got detected with cancer, and he was given about 3 to 6 months to live, but he went on to live about almost a decade,
20 years
since then. And over these years, he always felt like, you know, modern medicine was not 100% addressing the concern, the cause of the disease. right? If you or your body are at a dis-ease, that's when a disease will manifest. Why are you at a disease? He believed was because of our emotional well-being. So, you know, if I'm not feeling supported, let's say by my family, I will probably end up with a lower back pain. Or if I'm not feeling financially supported, I will end up with a lower back pain. So every disease is psychosomatic in nature. And he believed that if we take care of the cause of why a disease manifests in the human body, that the disease will heal itself. So he first believed in curing the cause and not the effect, which is the disease. Yeah. So his system was very simple. It was very easy to follow. So there are 38 remedies that are given to you, and there is a sheet. And if you can just figure out what is your emotional state of mind, what are the emotions that you need to address with those 38 remedies and the list that is given to you, you will be able to figure out a remedy mix for yourself. And when you start taking the remedies, you realize over a period of time that you start to feel better. Oftentimes, I've had clients who will say, you know, I can't quite tell what has shifted, but I can tell that something has shifted. And that's what happens at the initial consultation with her client. As we go along, you know, we go through a very beautiful journey with the emotions and the emotions healing, hence causing the physical symptoms to start to heal. So a lot of people question, you know, can this take care of my thyroid, diabetes, blood pressure, fever, cough, cold, stomach pain, hair loss? I get a lot of people asking me a whole lot of issues, but what I always bring them back to is that it is always your emotions that will matter to me. It is never your physical symptoms that will be considered when it comes to choosing a remedy. So the way that these remedies work, I will kind of make a diagram to explain it to you how these work before we go into our topic today. Have you ever heard of the anger iceberg? You know, where the tip of the iceberg is anger, but at the bottom there are a lot of other emotions that are connected with anger, which are not probably addressed. You know, a person comes across as very, very angry, but internally maybe that person is very, very hurt, and that's why they are projecting it as anger. So if you were to think now, excuse my drawing abilities, but this is just for demo purposes. Now, this is what I would say the core. Okay? Ye aapki jad hai. Over this, there is another layer. And then over this is another layer. And over that is another layer, and another layer, and another layer. And those layers go on and on and on, like an onion. Now, when I have to peel an onion, if you've ever looked at an onion, and if you've ever pulled it apart, you realize that the onion has a lot of layers. And you don't know how many layers in that onion until and unless you pull apart the first layer, and then the second layer, and then the third layer, and so on and so forth. Yeah. So if I am pulling this apart, first thing I have to do is I have to get rid of the top layer, right?
The outer layer.
And then you go to the second and the third and the fourth. So let's say that the person has started out, has come to you with anger. So I'm going to address the remedy that is for anger in that moment for that person, which is holy. okay? Normally, just a general overview. And then we've removed that top layer is gone, okay? We've removed this layer, and then we come to the second layer. And maybe over here, the person is feeling very hurt. So I will give them the remedy for hurt, which is Star of Bethlehem. And then we come, then once that heals, there is a third layer which has been exposed, which could be fear. Okay? And then I would give a fear remedy to that person, depending on what kind of fear that person has. Let's say that it could be an unknown fear. They don't know why they're so scared, but they're just a scared person. I would probably give them aspirin. So you see, as you, so these are, so holly, Star of Bethlehem, aspirin, these are all the names of batch flower remedies. Now every remedy has its own function, you know. So I would just keep going and going and going and going, layer after layer, peeling that onion of emotions that the person is feeling, so that that last layer is exposed, and then I can work on healing that. This is how the system works. Yeah, you can. Can I raise it? Well, it is important for everybody to know how a particular system works, right? Because until we don't know how it works, it might not really register in our heads. And the good part about this system is that it's very transparent. We don't have any hidden agenda. We'll always tell you what we are even putting in your mixing bottle. And that is how a very typical batch consultation would go for us. Yeah. So we understand so far, right? Simple, easy to follow. So Dr. Bach believed that keep it simple, keep it close to the nature, don't complicate it, keep it authentic, okay? And the authenticity of the system lies in its practice itself, yeah? And this is something very interesting to know about the batch flower system, is that because it's natural, because it has no biochemical ingredient in it, no artificial flavors, no additives, nothing that will harm you. The worst that can happen if you take batch flower remedies and they don't work is that nothing happens. Okay, so the worst that can happen is that nothing happens. The best that can happen is that it starts to take its effect on you and your emotions start to heal. Yeah, so you cannot go wrong with the remedies. Even if you make a mistake, there are no side effects. That's the beauty of this system. That's why we so happily enjoy practicing this system on plants, on animals, on humans, on babies, on pregnant women, which is what brings me to our topic today. So I started taking batch flower remedies regularly when I wanted to conceive. And I was diagnosed with PCOD, which is polycystic ovarian disease. And I was about 15, maybe 20 kilos overweight than what I am today. And the doctor said, oh no, there's no chance that you are getting pregnant naturally. And initially I did follow the medical system, and I'm not condoning the medicine, the modern day medicine. I have great reverence for it. I take, you know, my medicines whenever they are required. But when I needed the emotional strength to believe in myself that this is possible, that I can get pregnant, that I will get pregnant, that I will have a baby in my womb and I will be able to support it, I had to take the remedies. to emotionally support me forward in this journey. So I did take my supplements, I did take my medicines that the doctor asked me to. I also did a fertility treatment that I failed, which is when I went back to nature. And that was in fact something that really transformed my thinking about this system. I started out when I was not pregnant, but when I did get pregnant, I started to take the remedies more seriously. So the first remedy that I started to take was what we call as the emergency mix. Now, if you are at all aware of the bachelor remedies, the popular name for it is rescue remedy. It's the same thing. It's a combination of 5 different bachelor remedies put into a mix together so that you can take it, and it comes in a bottle by itself. And basically, the way that the name suggests, this mix is basically taken SOS. It should not be made into a regular bottle and taken all the time, except if you are really in need of all those 5 remedies that are present in the bottle. Popular mix, but it is not what the entire system is all about, because there are only 5 flowers in this. Yeah, and this is taken in a case of shock or trauma or a situation where you need SOS, like an SOS situation where you need to be rescued out of a situation. And I wouldn't say that is true for women who conceive, but initially, you know, when those 2 pink lines show up on the pregnancy test, it is a bit of a shock. It's a good shock, but it is a bit of a shock. Like, oh my god, this just happened. Like, how did this just happen? Like, the doctor said that, oh my gosh, you know, I'm not going to get pregnant. Like, oh, seriously, like, am I even seeing this right? You know, so it is a bit of a shock. It's very overwhelming, and that shock itself can make a woman miscarry. Yeah, so you know, there's a disbelief. It's like, huh, ho gaya. You know, like, I was preparing myself for over a year, and I really was, in my case. And the first month I was pregnant, I'm like, this can't be possible. You know, it's just not possible. So, you know, rescuing from that shock. So initially, when a person conceives, the best remedy to give is the emergency mix, or the crisis mix. That's the other name for it, which is crisis mix. So yeah, so the other name for it is also crisis mix, which basically means that you give it in a state of crisis. And if we look at a pregnant woman's journey of the 9 months, you know, the 40 weeks, 36 to 40 weeks, it's filled with transitions. And those transitions mark different things physically as well as emotionally for a woman. And a great, great, great remedy to give along with the emergency mix is the walnut. Has anyone over here heard about something called the doctrine of signature? So the doctrine of signature, it basically comes from, you know, homeopathy, Ayurveda, etc. Basically what they're saying is that the way a plant or a flower or a fruit behaves in nature, it is used as a remedy to cure that. Okay, so here of course it was taken from the walnut flower, but if we look at the walnut acrot, right? A walnut has a hard shell around the soft nut protecting it, right? So what do you think that this remedy will do?
Actually, that is good for
Yeah, but if we're looking at nature, right, I get that. But if we're looking at nature, the nature of the walnut, okay, although the remedy is taken from the flower, it's made from the flower, but if we're looking at the nut, what is the outer shell doing to the nut inside? What is it doing?
Protects.
It protects, right? So walnut is a remedy that works as a protection. Walnut is also a remedy that helps mark you the transition and also adjust with the transition. And in a pregnant woman's journey of those 9 months, every day is a transition, because no day will look like the first day. Okay, every day is a transition, and she needs the comfort and the protection that everything is going to be fine. That I am safe, that my child is safe, that everything is going to be fine. So it is protection as well as transition when it comes to the walnut remedy. So these were the two main remedies that I took throughout my pregnancy. Some of the other remedies that I did take were mimulus. Now mimulus, I'll write that down. I started taking it before my conception. Yeah, because I was told that I'm gonna probably have to go through IVF and all these things, but I just started taking it from the moment I conceived. Well, before I conceived, I took some remedies, and then when I conceived, I changed my bottle. And the first remedy that I, of course, started on was the emergency mix, walnut. The third remedy that I took was mimulus. And I would consider giving mimulus to a pregnant woman because she can have a lot of known fears. Okay, what if I trip and fall? What if I miscarry? That is the first priority. What if I miscarry? What if this is not a viable pregnancy? And all of these are possible. So mimulus is a remedy for known fears. Fears that are known, that can happen. And then there is another remedy, which is for fears of the unknown. You know, like the building can fall and we'll all die. That's an unknown fear. Like, yeah, it is possible. It is possible any minute. But it doesn't always happen. Right? So, the other remedy that I would consider is aspirin. And this one is for fears of the unknown origin. And this all together, I would say, is a great mix initially to start out with women who conceive. And when you start giving this, and because it is very safe for the mother to take it from the umbilical cord, the nutrition is going to the baby also. So the baby also receives the remedies through the mother while the pregnancy is going on. So it's a very beautiful thing, because the child is also growing up very whole and complete. Emotionally, the mother and child are both automatically balanced when they are taking the remedies. This is the beauty of the system. That, you know, you, and of course the neonatal vitamins and the prenatal vitamins, all of that is of course happening. I will never ever ever nullify the effects of modern medicine, but when you complement it with batch flower remedies, we call it a complementary treatment. Yeah, so when you complement it with batch flower remedies, you realize how beautifully the pregnancy will also go, how beautifully the baby will develop, and how emotionally balanced the mother and the child in the womb will feel. So I would initially in a pregnancy consider these, and then I would want to explore with the pregnant person, the pregnant woman, how is she feeling. Sometimes, you know, because of hormonal changes, she's not feeling grounded. Okay. Can I erase this?
Yes. Thank you.
So initially, yes, the crisis mix works very well, and it has the remedy that grounds a person. But let's look at a few more individual remedies. So we looked at so far mimulus, walnut, aspen. Then the other one that I would consider is clematis. Clematis is a remedy that grounds the energies. That kind of like zoop brings you back into the present. It makes you feel here and now, rather than the mind just wavering off with too many things. Oh, ye kaisa hoga, wo kaisa hoga, baby ka crib kaisa hoga. Like, just kind of brings you back into the present and lets you live in the present moment. Okay, if at all the mother has had a past trauma, for example, she is miscarried, or it's a stillborn baby, or it's an abortion, at that point in time I would consider honeysuckle, because honeysuckle is a remedy where, you know, it helps you once again bring you back into the present and not keep going back to that reference point of the past, that ye ho gaya to wapas, ye ho gaya to wapas, ye ho gaya to. So it keeps you in the present, that let's just enjoy the moment in the now. Yeah, so that is only if there has been a traumatic past, then honeysuckle would be recommended. The other remedy I would consider for a mother to be is olive. Olive is a remedy of fatigue. Feeling emotionally and physically very, very exhausted. And, you know, newly pregnant women can get very tired very easily and then they'll just fall asleep. It's very common. I'm sure you must have seen it in your families. And it is something that will just help her, you know, keep her energies up and going, and if need be, if she's feeling exhausted, it will allow her to rest. Okay, which is the other remedy? Okay, I might also consider a remedy called crab apple. Crab apple is a cleansing remedy. It's a detox remedy. It is a remedy that will perhaps help her with the morning sickness, nausea. It might also help the mother accept her body and the bodily changes, because, you know, if she is some beauty queen or is very particular about her figure, she will have a hard time accepting her rather large body, the growing belly. She will not enjoy it, and if she complains about that, I would consider crab apple, and I would also consider for morning sickness, because you're feeling so unclean and sick and dirty, and, you know, there are fluids coming out and all sorts of things that happen even physically in a woman's body. So crab apple is also a great remedy to consider for a pregnant mother. Yeah. Maybe we can take one more remedy before we close. Yes, one of the topmost remedies I would consider during pregnancy is red chestnut. Mother is always concerned, will my baby be okay, will my baby be okay, will my baby be okay? No, is my husband okay? I'm not taking care enough of him, he is the big baby, you know. No, ghar wale like sab theek to rahega, because I am not able to give in enough. And that brings me to one more remedy, which is pine. She might be feeling guilt of not being able to give enough to the family. because she might be so exhausted or might be, you know, just newly pregnant, might not be able to give the other child a time if there's another child, then also red chestnut pine could be considered. So as you see, there are different remedies for different situations and they will work differently for different people. But because our topic is of pregnancy, I just thought of considering these few remedies that you know, new mothers, pregnant women can get started with. And initially, of course, start with the emergency mix or the crisis mix. And these remedies are very easily available at any local homeopathic supply shop, like a Zoroastrian or Roy Raw, any of these homeopathic supply shops that keep homeopathic tinctures. You can ask for these remedies and they are very available with ease, or with one of us practitioners who are there, then we can give you a mix, or you could send them to one of us and it can be worked out as consultations. And yeah, then of course there is Help Library where I am giving talks and you guys can come and attend it and empower yourself with the knowledge of the remedies so that you can empower more people with it. So
these are not homeopathic medicine?
They are not homeopathy, but they are sort of like homeopathy. Yeah. They are not exactly homeopathy, but inspired by homeopathy, because Dr. Bach was inspired by Dr. Hahnemann's research as a homeopath, and he did learn to become a homeopath before he discovered the Bach flower remedies. So yes, and that's where the doctrine of signature carries forward. So a lot of them, not all of them, carry the doctrine of signature within them. The way that I described walnut, there are quite a few other plants also that follow the doctrine of signature with the Bach flower remedies. So, yeah.
White chestnut.
White chestnut. Well, if I'm not seeing white chestnuts show up so much in pregnant women, except if they really can't go to bed, or you know, they constantly have like one thought going on and on and on in their heads, it's more red chestnut that's rampant, more olive, more clematis, more of these remedies that I have over the years seen giving to my pregnant clients, and also when I was pregnant I took these. Yeah, so thank you so much for coming and I hope to see you guys soon.